Blackstone Audiobooks presents Squeeze Play by Jane Leavy. For Peter, who goes the distance. April. I guess I knew it was going to be a long, strange season the first time I called the front office and a voice answered, "Washington Senators, praise the Lord." This was the day Sal, my sports editor, told me I was going to be covering the team for the Trib. And a week after, the Reverend Jimmy Boy Collins acquired the franchise. This had all the makings of lunacy, right up front. Nice Jewish girl covers expansion baseball team owned by right-wing televangelist. Something told me it might be a good idea to write this all down just in case. So here it is, in the raw, so to speak. A.B. Berkowitz, October 1989. Opening Day. April 3rd. You see a lot of penises in my line of work. Short ones, stubby ones, hard ones, soft ones, circumcised and uncircumcised, laid back and athletic. Professionally speaking, they have a lot in common, which is to say they are all attached to guys, most of whom are naked while I am not, thus forming the odd dynamic of our relationship. They are athletes who believe in the inalienable right to scratch their balls anytime they want. I am a sports writer. My job is to tell you the score. Generally, I try not to look at their penises, which is why I always carry at least 2 felt-tip pens and a steno pad. This way I can take notes without staring at the glands of some poor son of a bitch who has just been demoted to AAA. But the fact is, penises have a way of intruding upon your field of vision, especially if you are 5'1", which I am. One time I was hiding behind my steno pad, talking to Tyrone Jackson, the basketball player, when my notebook began to quiver. After that, the line on Tyrone was, he really gets off on being interviewed. So I pretty much thought I had seen it all. Until today. My name is A.B. Berkowitz, and I have been a sports writer at the Washington Tribune for 9 months now. The initials stand for Ariadne Bloom, which is why everyone except Mom calls me A.B., and why the Washington Senators were a bit surprised the first time I showed up in their locker room. Usually when people find out what I do for a living, they want to know one thing. Who has the biggest schlong in America? You'd be surprised how many different ways there are to ask this question. Dolly Mitchell, the wife of the publisher, showed up at the Christmas party at Duke's, ate 40 shrimp balls, blushed, and said in that Betty Boop voice of hers, "So tell me, A.B., honey, just between us girls, who is the most impressive athlete you've ever met?" Sal practically hurdled the raw bar to get me before I could say anything. They didn't make him sports editor for nothing. 2 weeks later, he called me into his office and said, "You got the Senators beat. Don't say a fucking word to Mrs. Mitchell." Today, I got the answer to her question. The answer, Mrs. Mitchell, is the stick. It was 3 hours before game time, and everyone was working the room. Reporters, agents, assorted hangers-on. Everyone who ever made the A-list in Washington, or thought they should have. The clubhouse was strictly SRO. Opening day is always a zoo, but everybody in town wanted to be able to say they were there the day baseball returned to Washington. I talked to 5 senators, elected, 3 congressmen, Duke Zebert, the restaurant guy, Linda Carter, who used to be Wonder Woman, and Dick Bosman, who started the last game at RFK 18 years ago and learned belatedly the aerodynamic impact of tears on a major league fastball. Bosman gave up 5 runs and 8 hits in 5 innings that night, including 3 home runs, all of which he chalked up to tears. Still, the Senators were winning 7-5 with 2 outs in the top of the 9th when the last crowd to see Major League Baseball in Washington raged onto the field and refused to let the game end. Jim Honachick, the umpire, declared a forfeit at 10:11 p.m., and with that, Washington surrendered its right to be called a Major League city. Then last year, the Reverend Jimmy Boy Collins cut a deal to throw his considerable religioso support in the direction of a particular right-wing presidential candidate, the quid being a promise of an expansion franchise should said candidate get elected. The candidate is now president of these United States, as Jimmy Boy likes to say, and the Reverend Collins is owner of the Washington Senators. He calls his born-again Nats a divine reincarnation. Everybody figured when and if Washington got another team, it would be a National League franchise, what with the Birds in Baltimore. But the American League expanded first, and the president kept his promise, using his influence to get Jimmy Boy the franchise after the initial ownership went under. Jimmy Boy is also founder of the Christian Fellowship Entertainment Network, the slogan of which is, "Jesus rocks 24 hours a day," and Superstars Ministry, a Christian outreach program aimed at the spiritual needs of athletes. Jimmy Boy says that of all God's children, ballplayers are the most tempted, the most fallen, and the most needy of getting right with the Lord. On this much we agree. He also believes that ballplayers will be the vehicle by which the gospel of Jesus Christ is proclaimed worldwide, sports being the one thing, other than Jesus, we all have in common. This is why he bought the Washington Senators. "My mission is to suit him up, save him, and start him in the Lord's all-star lineup." I'll never forget the first time I met him.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.